We know our six contenders for the playoffs. The question is, who is going to join SK Gaming at the top of the table?
They are going to continue the top of the table charge, and what an immense turnaround for SK Gaming.
So we're number one in the regular season. We knew we could do it.
He's going to get caught around. The damage combined from Gambit is huge.
Today is our last match. We want to win this game.
A double kill for Zoas. A Fnatic takedown Gambit.
We just got to beat Rocket and we lock down that second place spot.
It's the last five games of Super Bowl.
Today's our last chance to secure the top two.
We still feel pretty good because we secured our spot in the playoffs.
There's definitely a potential for tiebreaker this split.
Everybody vying to get those last spots.
Who's going to lock in second place? We're going to find out today.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to day three of the final Super Week in the European LCS Spring Split. We're coming to you live from our studio here in Cologne, Germany. I'm Joe Millen, and I'm happy to be joined by Trevor Quickshot Henry. And well, with the standings constantly changing and every team showing that they can beat each other, it's been a wild ride. But after today's matches, our standings will be locked and our playoff brackets filled.
Yeah, the fact that we won't fully know what those positions are until later in the day really reflects how close the standings are. And the ties that we've had throughout the season really just illustrate how strong all of these teams are and the skill that they're bringing to the Rift.
So let's talk about what we do know for sure right now. There's not a lot of it, to be honest. No. Still everything up in the air. With their two wins yesterday, SK Gaming was able to secure the top seed going into the playoffs.
Yeah, as a team, they showed patient play. They came back from being behind Super Hot Crew's siege composition. They took a fight and the Baron to earn the first victory on the day. Then from there, the momentum that they gained allowed them to steamroll over the Copenhagen Wolves with a team score of 18-4-35. To say that SK Gaming looks anything less than a top-of-the-league team is a flat-out lie.
And of course, the top seed in the playoffs gives them an all-important bye directly into the semi-finals, where they'll play the winner of a best-of-three between the teams that finish in fourth and fifth.
Yeah, so let's actually take a look at that playoff bracket. Right now, we know that Fnatic, Alliance, and Rocket can all possibly finish in that second seed position. So at this point, the best Gambit can finish in is third, and the Copenhagen Wolves, they are hoping to climb up to fifth.
Another thing that will be decided is whether we have tiebreaker games after our regularly scheduled matches today. The way that tiebreakers work in the LCS breaks down like this. Ties are decided by the head-to-head records between the teams, and if any team owns that record, they automatically break the tie and advance. But, and here's the funny part, if the head-to-heads are tied, a tiebreaker match must be played to determine the winner.
Okay, so in the case of a two-way tie with a tied head-to-head record, that means one additional game will be played. In the case of a three-way tie, one team must own the head-to-head over both of the other teams to advance. If that is not the case, then a single round robin consisting of those three teams will be played. If there is no clear ranking of teams after those games, then the teams will be drawn into a single elimination bracket with one team getting a bye straight to the finals.
Could mean lots and lots more extra awesome games for us today, but let's take a quick look at where our teams currently stand in the rankings. First of all, we know it already. SK Gaming securing that first spot with 17 wins, 10 losses. In second, right now at least, is Fnatic at 16-11. In third comes then Rocket 15-12, and Alliance bring up fourth on 14-12.
Next up is Gambit in the fifth position at 14-13. The last playoff team is the Copenhagen Wolves. They are 12-14. Then we look at Super Hot Crew and Millennium, 10-17, 9-18. Those two spots could be changing depending on how the games play out today.
And of course, yesterday's games brought us some hashtag LCS big plays. Here's a look at your top two most tweeted about moments. Up first is from the Gambit versus Fnatic game where Edwards Leona stole the Baron.
Well, this one comes to us from at Ghost Reaper, and he says, praise the sun! Hashtag LCS big plays, Leona too strong. This was your second most talked about play.
Only chance in this game, the spears come through, Dark Bindings will start to land, there's the ultimate coming!
What? He got it!
They got it! Leona picks up the Baron! Edward will go down afterwards. Absolutely crazy stuff to steal that Baron away with the solar flare. Our most talked about clip, though, came from Alliance versus Millennium and features Jay Reid threading the needle. This one came from at Tacos EUW. The Jay Reid hook into tabs to get him into Curb's Mega Inferno Bomb was just awesome to watch. This is your number one LCS big play.
We're going to try and close the gap here. It's going to be another overdrive. Power Fist comes in. That's going to be four members. They're going to Mega Inferno Bomb comes down. Tabs is taken low. He gets taken down by Connex once again.
Absolutely fantastic hook, and when you make them land, you win the games. You guys at home, remember to send us your favorite plays from today's games by tweeting at LOL Esports and using that hashtag LCSBigPlays.
And we'd like to remind you that voting is currently underway for the upcoming 2014 All-Star event that will be held in Paris, France, beginning on May the 8th. Just head over to vote.lolesports.com, and from now through April 12th, you can pick three pro players every single day from any combination of teams you want to represent your region. And remember that the top two pros in the voting will get to partake in the All-Star Challenge, where they will join one of two teams created from other stars from around the world.
I'm looking forward to seeing how those teams shape up. And of course, if the players are part of the top team from Europe, then they will be competing in the All-Star Invitational, where they will face the best teams from each of the five regional pro leagues. This means that while Reckless is in the lead right now, if Fnatic win first place in the playoffs, any player in the top votes still has a chance to compete at the event. And with 10 days left to vote, absolutely anyone can still earn a trip to Paris and represent the European LCS.
Now let's take a look ahead to today's games as we close out the spring split. Up first, it's Millennium versus SK Gaming, first versus eighth, and then we move into the Copenhagen Wolves versus Super Hot Crew.
Second half of the day takes a look at Alliance as they take on Gambit. Fnatic will be battling Rocket, Fnatic looking at that second place. And last game of the day will be Alliance versus the Copenhagen Wolves.
And you guys can continue to track these teams through the spring split playoffs and beyond, as well as get stats, watch VODs of games and more over on lolesports.com. That's also why you'll find the schedule and vote on today's games. Make sure you make your selections, and we'll check in before each match to see who you pick to win.
Yeah, and remember that you can grab seats and actually join us here in Cologne, Germany to see the European LCS live. You can also get tickets for the North American LCS in Los Angeles. Their final Super Week kicks off on Friday. Seats are still available, but they're going fast. You can find all the details on the tickets link.
Now it's time for you to hop on Twitter so we can pick your brain and tell us which European LCS team have you most enjoyed watching this split and why?
All of them, Joe.
That was the easy answer, wasn't it?
You guys at home can send us your answers to at LOL Esports and be sure to mark them with the hashtag LCS so Shox can see them and read our favorite responses later in the day.
Well, let's head over to Shox, who's standing by with two players who will face each other across the rift in our second game today.
Thank you very much, Joe. I am standing by with Youngbuck from the Copenhagen Wolves and Impaler, the jungler for the Super Hot Crew. And well, yesterday you guys were both still in the running to make it in the playoffs. In the end, it was the Copenhagen Wolves that secured that spot. And Impaler, I saw you tweeting at Edward when he said, we'll see you next split. You were like, oh, I don't know if we'll be around. I can imagine it must have been a tough blow, but what is it like today after you've had some time to spend with the team?
We're still confident that we're going to be around, and we just need to improve as much as we can in those 3 weeks. And provided we play seventh, which is possible, and like a good prospect for us, then I think we'll be fine.
All right, good to see that you have that confidence back. And then for you, Youngbuck, of course, you guys secured your spot in the playoffs. Tell me a little bit about your performance here the last 2 days. A very solid plan versus Gambit, and then versus SK Gaming, it didn't go so well.
Going into the week, we were very stressed about the game versus Super Hot Crew because we knew that Gambit and SK were favorites, and we expected them to pick up a win earlier in the week, so we would have been even going into this match. But yesterday, they managed to lose against SK, and I think we were a lot happier than SK.
Managed to lose. SK was, of course, very strong in that one as well. You guys are still playing today, although there isn't that much weight on it. How do you think that game's going to play out? You're going to play for all your money's worth, I can presume.
We're going to try our best. Like, just because we haven't qualified for the promotion tournament side of things, we'll still try our best, and we'll still try and make the fans happy.
Talking about that promotion tournament, how much thought have you put into going into that? And, you know, if you're able to pick who you want to pick, is that already on your mind?
Like, NIP are looking like the strongest amateur team. They've already had a lot of practice here on the competitive level as well. So if we have to face them, then we'll come all guns blazing, but hopefully not.
And as for you, Youngbuck, going into the playoffs, after what you've seen here from all the teams that are also going to those playoffs, how do you expect that you can do?
It's very tough to call. Everyone can beat everyone here, especially the top six teams. But we may have a little bit of an advantage in a tournament setting because we've played a lot of tournaments in the challenger scene.
Yeah, absolutely. And Impaler, you guys, of course, had made a roster change a couple of weeks ago to maybe avoid going into promotion tournament. How do you reflect on how it's gone with Selfie going 0-3 here so far? Is of course not the ideal scenario.
It's still going well with Selfie. Like, our problems are pretty clear. We keep coming out of lane phase ahead. Like, versus SK, the number one team, we were out of laning phase, 6k gold ahead playing Poke Comp. We just need to learn how to transition that lead to the mid game, and then I'm sure we'll be able to compete with any of the top teams with ease.
A lot of confidence there. Young Buck, if you reflect on your performance going at it in split here, you know, transitioning from the amateur scene now of your first split in the LCS, do you feel like you guys as a team have grown a lot?
Yeah, and I definitely think that we underestimated the experience that other teams had, because the way we went into the split with the mindset was, looking back, was terrible. We weren't used to losing, and when we started losing in the LCS, it was really hard to deal with.
I can imagine that. Well, you've learned a lot. Next, I want to pick your brains on the first matchup here of the day. It's going to be Millennium versus SK Gaming. What do you think, Impaler?
We'd kind of need SK to win to secure our seventh place. But if they don't, then I'm sure we'll just beat Copenhagen Wolves. But I think SK will take it anyway.
Young Buck, any reply?
I'm going to give it to SK. These guys are brilliant when it comes to strategies and champion select.
And are you going to beat them later or?
Yes, we are.
Obviously, it's going to be a great matchup. Thank you very much, gentlemen. And it's time for us to take a quick break, but stay with us because our first match of the day will be a battle between 8th place and 1st place when Millennium take on SK Gaming. We'll be right back.